Alright, welcome back. So, we're back in the mind of the ethereal once more. There were a few options I missed last time, so...
Was he like this before that thing took over? That fits with his file. Damn it. I should have seen it earlier. Looks like this. Ethereal is the real hero.
Aw, we're the hero. It's so cute.
More confirmation that Carter is indeed an asshole.
Yeah.
What do we know about it? Proven effectiveness. Possibly telepathic. Damn, it can hear me, can't it?
Some really good detail. Delivery, sorry, on that line.
Damn.
Focus, Alan. This is no time for distraction. The other two can handle Carter, but this ethereal needs a new host, and I must admit, it would be a unique opportunity.
Get in me. And there's even more, so one more time.
Yes.
If you still can't decide...
There is a ton of dialogue for this.
You space squid?
See, it's a space squid.
Here. If Will won't work with you, I can. For now.
She doesn't seem too keen on it.
If you can hear me, then you know we're out of options. There's too much at stake. I will become your host. For now, merge with me and let's end this together.
Very pragmatic. Doesn't seem like it'd be a lot of fun to merge with Falk.
Yeah, but you know, I don't expect this is a picnic.
And we can hardly spare the director or Agent Weaver, especially now that we've lost our best man. That settles it then. Ethereal being, if you can indeed hear me, then I humbly volunteer for duty.
Yeah, I guess solely on the merits of the character dialogue, you'd pick this one.
Yeah, and the thread went pretty overwhelmingly with Weir, so...
Yeah.
Here we are.
Interesting decision.
Greasy.
That is the same line you would hear if you decided to explode. Just fade to black, you hear that, and then game over.
Yeah. Also, that is a,
It comes to this.
It's one hell of a weak-ass pistol whip, but... Eh,
oh,
whatever.
Yeah. You could have used a nice thunk or something.
Yeah.
This is Director Falk to all XCOM personnel remaining in the field. In the event that you are receiving this transmission, it means that I have issued a Code Alpha evacuation order. Do not approach the area known as Site X. Consider all XCOM assets at Site X to be dead or destroyed. Do not attempt to recover.
I love that sectoid, just...
To those of you that survive...
He's getting his own back.
Yeah.
Remains.
Survive, Bob the Muton escaping.
Adapt. Win. Do not stop until the last...
Falk takes a drag of his cigarette as the gate closes.
Ah, fuck it. Ah, god damn it.
12th base I've had blown out from under me this week. I mean, year.
So the little mission description here changes, of course, depending on who you pick.
Mm-hmm. I think that screenshot is actually from a previous version of the level... Of the last level, where you actually walked up to the tank. I don't think it's from the cutscene.
Yeah, it doesn't quite look like it matched anything that we saw.
Nope. That level was originally much longer. But here we are, heading to God knows where to try and deliver a knockout punch.
Agent Weaver, bring us up to speed.
Let's see. Our base just got destroyed. A massive outsider ship is currently hovering over our planet. And, as we just saw, Mosaic is somehow still functioning and controlling the outsider's actions. That about sums it up.
How? Didn't we blow the Mosaic core to Kingdom Come and Origin along with it?
Origin is alive, in a sense. His consciousness lives on inside Mosaic, much as Origin's ethereal did, acting as the power source for the remaining network. Origin has enough power of his own to hold the new Mosaic core together and broadcast commands through it, but he's not nearly as powerful as his imprisoned ethereal was, which leads me to believe that he and the new Mosaic core are aboard the Outsider command vessel.
If he's acting as the new battery for Mosaic, why aren't the Outsiders massing to take us out?
Origin is powerful, but not nearly as powerful as an ethereal. In its current state, Mosaic can only broadcast short distances, probably not even beyond the vessel.
So what are you suggesting we do?
I'm stronger than he is. Get me access to the new Mosaic core, and I'll take it from him. The Outsiders will follow whatever command I give them. One command, and the war ends.
The core can be accessed by destroying power relays at these points. One in a weapons and armor manufacturing cluster, one in a biological research center, and then the master relay in the central location.
So we take those out and the core is just wide open.
In order to circumvent the automated repair redundancies, all relays must be destroyed simultaneously, which is to say, we need to destroy them at the same time, or we have no chance.
It's we know decided. What simultaneously we means. Go
hey man, he's a scientist. Maybe other people don't know what that word means.
A lot of blinky stuff in this room.
Yeah, a lot of blinky things. So it's worth noting that this is the first time where an evil overlord has had something that isn't single point vulnerable, actually requires coordination, and has the vulnerable point separated by a goodly distance of space. Amazing, it's almost like he thought about it.
Are you all right, Director? Is there anything I can do to help?
Yes. Bring back my base, my agents. Then, wipe the Outsiders from the skies and make sure they never threaten my...
And give me a pony.
He's an ethereal, not a genie.
Yeah, pretty much.
I think Falk is fundamentally misunderstanding the nature of the ethereals.
You're basically a magician, right? We've lost,
except the people. Or do people not register for ethereals?
You know me better than that, Myron. You've seen me fight to protect humanity.
What does the real doctor think of you?
And of course, you get to choose what to say. Well, because you're in control. Like Weir doesn't have much of a, He has a constant doesn't have much of a choice about the dialogue, huh?
To get answers.
That sounds like him.
This is a unique situation in that the ethereal is now prescient and actually aware that it's sort of in control, whereas before it wasn't. I mean, he was basically thought he was Carter.
Yep.
I guess we didn't kill him enough the first time.
He had centuries to study an ethereal. It's not too surprising he picked up some tricks along the way.
Jesus Christ, he's an ethereal now?
No, his power is not complete. He can't control and sustain Mosaic as Shamash, the other of my kind, was able to.
You
realize we may not survive this. You and I may die in the attempt, and humanity will be left without its protectors.
I see three outcomes. In two, humanity dies. In one, it has a chance. That one involves attacking Origin and Mosaic.
Agreed.
What are the other two?
Origin will hunt us down if given enough time.
I don't know. Attempting to rebuild Mosaic. I don't really know what that line means.
I would have been happier if the bastard had stayed dead.
We all would. But right now, we need to act quickly. We have to attack before he does.
You're really terrified of this Mosaic thing, aren't you?
Terrified? No. Neither of us wants to be enslaved. Our interests lie together.
It's interesting that,
talked enough.
Never thought I'd hear that coming out of the character's mouth.
Enjoy the novelty.
Canonically, of course, this means that Origin has, well, congratulations, he's become part of the Singularity. He's uploaded himself into Mosaic. Oh, God.
Blurp.
Yup. Cue Blue Danube.
Yeah, you can keep looking at that, but it only lasts for like 3 seconds. And on the other side...
And here's our destination. This is Origin's Deathticle. His giant Jax piece in the sky. Or something.
Doctor,
There's no need to fear me, Agent Weaver.
Doctor,
I'm still remembering you, as well as the ethereal you worked with.
It's not fear I'm feeling. Actually, I have a question. The Outsiders came here looking for an ethereal. If you hadn't been on Earth, would they have left us alone?
A very good question. And one that you should already know the answer to if you've been paying attention.
They would have attacked Earth eventually. It might have been next year, or a century from now.
Because they destroyed their own planet. If you ethereals are supposed
exactly.
to help
their driving goal was to
itself,
find a new habitable world because they were all shit out of luck.
Josh was killed by Carter.
And Angela's question does pose a bit of a, yeah.
His curiosity will make you question everything. Have either of you figured out our next step?
Yeah, we've been talking about it for like the past 30 minutes.
Yes. The answer is we shoot things, you see, by shooting them, and, yeah.
How did either survive? We blew up the Mosaic core. We killed Origin.
Origin built Mosaic a very long time ago. He has abilities we haven't guessed at. Their mothership is the target. We'll need to defeat Origin and Mosaic in order to take the ship.
What do you intend to do with it once you have it? If we survive.
Study it. Outsider technology is quite vast compared to our own.
I mean, you know, we basically will have a Death Star if we capture it, so yeah, keep it.
That thing is a weapon.
It damn sure is a weapon, and it's a really good one, too.
Origin must be top priority. It was his genius that created Mosaic, after all.
His genius? You respect him?
He was once a scientist. I must admit I have a certain fellow feeling.
You better not follow in his footsteps. I won't hesitate to take you down if I have to.
I could expect no less from you, Agent Weaver.
There is a lot of dialogue in this ship.
Oh, yeah.
I never thought I'd hear you say that.
It's good dialogue, though.
It is good dialogue, and it was the last chance that anybody had to get any character building or, you know, character confirmation in. And so it was just like, well, this is your entire base, basically, so... I have a lot of dialogue here.
Never thought I'd see XCOM blown to hell.
Not all of XCOM. After all, we're still here.
I guess you're right, Doc. But it kind of takes the heart out of you, you know?
Be nice or be an asshole?
Canonically, I suppose the Ethereal is nice.
And I doubt they will while you're piloting.
Oh, you got that right.
I certainly do. We also have an Ethereal. The same can't be said for our enemy.
Right. That alien you and Director Falk were talking about. You bonded with it?
I wish we had the budget for more facial animation, because a nice big eyebrow raise would have been great here.
Better off not knowing too much more.
If you say so. Almost time for our last stand, isn't it?
Either that, or they'll hunt us all down.
Should we maybe find somewhere safe and do repairs first?
We don't have the time.
That dude on the outside will be just fine. He'll just hang on. Rebuilding the Mosaic
network. If you say so, Doc. I just wish we had more time.
We all do. We have the ability and the resources. We owe it to humanity to defend it. To the death, if need be.
There isn't anyone else, is there? We haven't heard anything from other countries.
They may already be gone.
So that's not true. Like, at all.
No one. Whatever species they may be can attack Earth and get away with it.
I do think it would have been a funny,
Let us say I have a certain intuition that there are more intelligent life forms in the universe.
Let's just hope they're friendly.
I have it on good authority some are.
I think it would have been really freaking funny if you're ready to fly, Barnes.
I was born ready.
Like, yeah, like, the Avenger lands on the alien spaceship, and as you get there, like, a Soviet craft is simultaneously dispatching a team, and you guys can, like, bro-fist and take the aliens out together.
That is a great idea. That was originally one of the DLC plans we had hashed out, was, De Silva. It was actually, De Silva goes to, De Silva goes to Russia, basically. It was De Silva goes to the Russian XCOM, and does a little exchange program there to try and convince them to help us. We would get agents. We would have gotten female agents, too. That was one of the things on the table for that DLC in particular. Because it was something people really wanted to do, but there was just no way we could do it, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. And I just wanted to switch out quartermasses, which I'm, again, yeah, someone pointed out in the thread, it's supposed to be quartermass, not quartermass.
Yeah, I've made the same mistake myself before I watched the series, but... Yeah,
I was considering the corrosive plasma pack, but I gave him the quick charge pack.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what you take into this mission. There aren't that many resupplies in this mission, and your squad composition is very important.
My favorite is sniper support, so I'm just going to stick with Darzan Gargle and Quartermass.
If you're playing this on Commander, you probably are going to want two snipers.
All right.
Oh, yeah, so, something no one mentions, of course, is that, yes, the ship is, well... blowing the fuck out of Earth right now, as you see.
Yeah.
Yeah, Origin's kind of, he's kind of gone pissy on us.
Nice landing pad, though.
Well, yeah. The Outsiders need to land their own ships on this thing, too.
is a pretty area.
Is the epitome of outsider architecture. And yeah, so that whole thing about an armada, yeah, there's an armada. And it's flying right at Earth.
Yeah, there's a lot of things going towards our little blue marble.
Yeah, it's not a good sign. So this ship, there's a lot of things to be very proud about this ship from the whole team's perspective. One of the great ones to be proud of, though, is the fact that the ship is not a TARDIS. This huge ship is to scale. It actually fits the entire level inside it, and then some.
Neat.
Yeah. This level tested the limits of our skybox technology. Quite heavily. It also tested the limits of our lighting technology quite heavily, and unfortunately it became wanting a little bit. Also, first and only lens flare in the game, I believe.
And an entirely appropriate one, because we are looking straight at the actual sun.
And another first in this entire game. An actual, honest-to-God, moving platform. This is the only one in the game.
No, there's another.
There is?
Yes.
A horizontal one, not a vertical. Oh, okay. Vertical ones have a different set of problems than horizontal ones. Now,
we can then focus on curing the sleepwalkers. You will have my full concentration.
We already cured the sleepwalkers.
Well, yeah. My son, he... Yeah, this dialogue is not 100%.
I don't know how long it will take.
Tied in with all the other stuff, but whatever.
I'm with you, Doc, all the way.
Nice little revelation about Barnes.
Yeah, Barnes has a son that he's worried about. Who knew?
Go!
I'm very happy that you didn't look down the elevator shaft while we were traveling on it, because there's a pretty nasty lighting bug that shows up there. If you do that.
Just checking out the plasma
cannons. Those are unique cannons. Those are unique plasma cannon models. They don't appear anywhere else in the game.
Man. I was trying to determine where over the Earth we were, but you can't really make out any continental lines.
I used to know this. I think actually we're supposed to be above the west coast of the U.S.
Would make sense. I mean, I imagine they would try and be over X-Men headquarters.
Yeah, Nevada.
Or nearby.
West coast of the U.S. So yeah, here
we
are.
I just love looking at the ships floating around.
Yeah, I really do. I really do love this area. Also, I spent a lot of time here, mainly because for lighting and performance and all that.
Well, if you had to pick a place to stay, it's not a bad one.
No, it's not. We tried to get the Earth a little bit higher res, but couldn't quite manage it. It's still fairly good, though, considering that it's actually part of the skybox.
A lot of mushroom clouds down
there
on the continent.
Yeah, a lot of things getting blown the fuck up. So this is how Origin is now communicating with the Outsiders now that he's uploaded himself. He kind of has to use the psychic PA system.
Byron, off to the deployment wing. Angela, you're going to weapons manufacturing. Radio when you're in place.
Understood.
On it.
And of course all this shifts depending on who you decided to go with.
Mm-hmm. All those
everyone's taking
helmets.
Their helmets off. Physics!
Physics objects. Yeah, the helmets are physics objects. Affected by weapons fire. This used to be the place in the game with the most physics objects, but unfortunately we discovered you could get them stuck in the doors and really screw everything up, so we had to ditch them. We had to ditch the chairs in the next room, I believe, or something you can particularly see.
I assume that's a little streaming out section.
Absolutely it is. This level has a lot of those. You're not going to have to work very hard to find them, sorry, but they're absolutely essential. Otherwise, this map goes nowhere.
It's a big place.
It is a big fucking map with a lot of areas and a shitload of architecture. So we're in our...
Jesus.
We're in our obligatory air vent section. Dun-dun-dun.
Ah, miss.
So, funny thing about those guys, those aren't enemies. You can't actually shoot them. Those are just animated meshes. And they have to be, otherwise the agents will start screeching and yelling and flipping out.
Oh, yeah.
Do you actually think we're getting out of this alive?
Oh, yeah, now this is a little optional corridor.
No.
Now, apparently I was told that Well, this is where I found it in the first place, but there's a thing here.
This is where most people find it.
Yes. Apparently you can find this in the X-Base during the last mission, but I didn't, so here's where you get it.
All right.
Lightning cannon.
This is not a lightning cannon. Anyone who's not retarded recognizes what that is. Yes, that's a piece of a Titan that they slapped into a gun. It's a disintegration ray.
It is a nice thing. It kind of functions more like a railgun from like a gameplay's perspective.
I don't believe it penetrates targets, but holy hell, it fucks up whatever it hits.
Oh yeah.
Keep that thing fed and you won't need to worry about almost anything else.
Yeah, it has a very low ammo capacity, but it doesn't need
it. Yeah, it takes things out quite handily. It might still have the disintegration sound effect on it. I mean, VFX on it.
Blurbs.
Yep. So, this is where you really should start putting together what blobs mean to the outsiders, if you haven't already figured it out. They're basically the nanotech immune system of outsider technology. So they're everywhere. They're in the walls. They're like the blood of the structure.
I've reached the security.
Which is white blood cells and red blood cells put sort of combined together.
How are you feeling,
precisely,
Angela?
Haven't seen much of the enemy. They're too focused on what's going on down below.
So this is an armory little area here. This is an armory, although it's been divested of stuff.
There's all these little doohickeys on the floor and stuff that I've never seen before.
Yeah, there was a big effort to put a lot of weird alien doodads in this level to make sure that it looked like a very, very bizarre place that still had some sort of vaguely humanoid touches into it. I love the floor here.
That does look cool.
It really does just go down for like 100 feet with extra meshes and stuff. And here's the patrol.
Move it! Yeah, just sectoids. Nothing to write home about.
That's the last of them.
Right through the door.
Oh. Whoops. I guess that door doesn't have ragdoll collision.
My bad.
And I do say my bad because this was one of the levels I tested the most.
This was the other moving platform, but was there ever another a vertical one in the game?
Yes, originally in the X-Base.
Right.
And some,
I thought we had agents watching him.
And who do you think let him loose?
Carter, silver-tongued ass.
You all right?
I caught a slug from Carter.
So if you didn't hate Carter already, you really should hate him now.
He just shot Barnes.
He shot Barnes, for fuck's sake.
But I'll live. He only got me in the lake.
That's our pilot, Carter.
Be careful. He's after the ethereal.
Well, he won't have it. You sit tight, Barnes. We'll get through this.
Yeah, for those watching, pay close attention to what Carter says and does in this section, because it's going to be extremely relevant very soon.
If you've ever had any sympathy for Carter, this level should disabuse you of it. This is what Carter's like when he's not got an ethereal stuck inside his skull. And so, the core of the Outsider spaceship is a fuck-off giant seed.
Listen to me. One of you is infected by the ethereal.
One of you.
Don't listen to it.
And what would you have me do, Carter?
Kill them. All the Outsiders, all the Sleepwalkers, anyone and anything that's been compromised.
That's genocide. I can't do that.
And we are pretty deliberately comes down on the UN side of things.
And you mentioned before the goo.
Yep.
Those are giant goo canisters.
Yep, those are blob tanks, basically. A friend of mine actually did the material for that.
Cool.
The barrier is just up ahead.
This doesn't look like a combat encounter.
Not a bit.
Oh, look, a force field.
There.
Moving now.
We've
moving.
Never had to take down a force field in this game before.
There.
Nope.
Actually. It's funny that we managed to get all the sort of cliches.
This ends here. I'm not going to allow mankind to be enslaved. Not by you, not by them, not by anyone.
Onto us. Death. So close.
Agent Weaver, stay.
status!
God damn it! Enemy inbound!
Kata, what have you done?
I stopped you.
Subtitles were a little too slow to keep up with that dialogue.
So did Carter just, like, sound the alarm?
Yep, that's exactly what he did. He sounded the alarm for the entire vessel.
The Ethereal must have allowed Carter to communicate like this with his squad.
Sorry, perhaps the mouse sometimes messes up whenever I try to select the other guy.
Oh, yeah. That was one of the few issues with the PC TAC mode that we didn't have the time to resolve, which is that if you have your mouse over one of the selector areas, sort of,
and you use the keyboard to try and select someone else, as soon as the mouse moves, it goes back to its original position.
Right, because the mouse gets priority when it moves. So,
but then again, easy to fix. Just move your mouse. So,
yeah, just,
not a massive problem.
It's basically just choose whether you want to use the mouse or the keyboard with TAC mode. Don't try and combine the two, and you'll be okay.
Yeah, this can be a pretty tricky encounter. There's a lot of things that hit extremely hard, so...
This encounter is a gloves-fully-off encounter, and this entire map, actually.
See Daisy, then?
This whole level is gloves-off.
Bring him down!
The level designers were given absolutely no restrictions on any encounters in this map, other than you have to have fewer than a certain number of AIs on screen at a time. That was it. Enemy mixes, there were no prescriptions on anything. They were basically like, do whatever you want.
I don't know how that guy got launched. Something exploded near him.
I don't know. I didn't catch it.
Oh well. There's not much ammo in this area either, so you gotta be kinda careful.
Yeah, you gotta be careful in this encounter. These encounters can be very, very rough. If you haven't already figured out how to deal with anything, This is going to be really painful. You're really not going to like it.
Yeah, and my mind control's already worn off, but I controlled the minion commander first.
Yep.
And now I want him dead.
Shield sphere, over there!
Yeah, you don't want that guy to start making drones.
And again, keep your shields up as much as you can. Because they are invaluable.
This encounter space used to be twice as big, but had to be shortened and made a little smaller because it was too easy for the enemies to flank you.
Well, yeah, there's all those sections to the left and right where it looks like it easily could have been more people.
Yeah, originally,
which would have been an absolute nightmare to fight in.
Yeah, originally those two pillars right near where you just placed the diversion weren't there, and that area was actually open. All those gaps to the left and right were closed off with flooring, so the enemies could run out of three different entrances. Were scripted to take up position in three different places, and then would immediately flank the hell out of you from both sides.
Stop
it was
that
a
bastard.
Little too realistic. Kind of in that, you know, you're only three people. What chance do you have against, you know, 20-plus man defense force? Not much.
Exactly. Here we go. Waiting. There we go. That's a full half of the Sectopod's health off.
Yeah.
What do we do?
Yep, we have the disintegration effect on that thing still, yeah. Which is...
I accidentally just picked up a plasma cannon instead, and the thing disappeared on me.
Yeah, unfortunately it does that.
If there's no ammo and you swap out for another weapon, I think the original one disappears. But anyway.
Yep, so you can't pick up an empty weapon.
Falk, where?
However, it's going to be in your resupply cache.
Yes.
So who's it gonna be? Who's the mighty Ethereal gonna choose?
And we have yet another choice.
Yeah, Carter forced into choice in his typical fashion. So who do we save?
I will leave that up to you guys, but I think I'm gonna predict that you guys are probably gonna go with Falk.
Chivalry is truly dead.
Well, in the big picture, the person who's probably more important to the fate of humanity is probably the guy who organized everything.